بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد. اخيارتا علماء الدين كودياشا قبلها دلنيردا دمان تدوينها ماشن اسكوغو اماده. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. رنهانتي وشرف آد أوين أيتها هي عاو إن لندن إن لتشوغا أو فرصة أن إني هلا إن مر لواد أن إنوسو زيارتا إيدو مدعي كسوريتي واجي يقدم بي أو لندن أن إنو كل ما لندن واجي أن إنو كل ما يي وحوها وقتي أن كامبين إي أورلا دورشا أن كجرني مانتنا وواكلا ويان wa zaban oo aan inigu soo laabtay aniga oo ka hadlaayo dawladdi Garissa County ka dhismatay iyo wixii ay qabatay oo aan doonaa inaan waxooga aan inii muujiyo ama arti aynu ka sheekaysano hadii waa hore aan inii imaaday aniga oo barnaamijki aan fulin rabno ma arti inuu soo bandhigayo iyo waxaan niyad aan ku haynay waxa maanta i faraxa inaan ma arti halkan aan inagu soo laabtay oo aan inaan maartay inagala sheekaysan doono waxaabihii ilaa hadda noo qabsoomeen iyo hindisooyinka kale oo aan ku fikirayno inaan accountigana ka qaban insha Allah ta'ala. Marka waad ku mahadsantihiin dhammaantiinba sida wanaagsan aad noogu imaateen oo aad uga soo qayb qasheen xafladan ama munaasabadan. Waxaan ogsoon yahay dad baa inaan cabaar aad fadhideen oo la ii sheegay ilaa iyo saacada la fadhiyay waad ku mahadsantihiin. Daa'iman ree London waxaad noqoteen dad wanaagsan oo martida inay imaato soo dhaweysiin waad ku mahadsantihiin insha Allah ta'ala. Thank you very much. Waxaan doonaa inaan ka bilaabo sheekada ama presentation-ka aan siinayo. Awalan anaga markii meesha aynu qabanay Garissa County oo aan shaqada bilaawnay waxaan horta aan ku bilaawnay wax la dhahaa New York County. Maxay leeyahay wax cusub baynu bilaabaynay, totally new county ayaa maartay markaa gacanta noo soo gashay. Marka waxay dhahaan resource mapping ayaynu gudagalnay in countygeena aan horta ogaano bal muxuu yahay waxa kan gacanta noo soo gale intee buu la'eg yahay tira ahaan dadkiisa nidaam ahaan. Marka know your country ayaynu gudagalnay. Haddaynu gudagalnana horta waxaynu ka bilaawnay inaan ogaano meesha aynu ka taaganahay Kenya oo ama 47 countries ka waddanka waad arkaysiin. Who are our neighbors? Intii markaan soo koobnay aan ogaanay ayaa haddana aan sii gudagalnay wixii kale oo markaas aan county ka ogaan lahayn in terms of population, in terms of area size kena and many other small information. What is also interesting is rainfall ka average ka ayaa wuxuu yahay 300. Waxaan actually ogaanay meelaha qaar oo county gena kamid ah they get much more higher rain than other parts of Kenya, like sida aad arki doontiin oo mathalan meelaha xeebta oo kale lamid ah. Marka waxaan ogaanay countygan oo aan lagu qiyaaso inuu yahay county iska arid ama semi arid wixii doona hal la dhaho, actually it's not homogeneous ma aha, waa a county of diverse contrasts and a different ecological characteristics. waxaanu soo baxday inuu yahay county ila iyo shan qaybood loo qaybin kara in terms of ecological marti characteristics ka western ka or riverine ka region ka ah oo weega saaran the northern wadis ka ama togogga marti oo north ka ah eastern ka oo ila iyo Soomaaliya qabanaayo oo savanna plains ah the central plains of Fafi iyo Degega and for that matter the southern of Boni forest maana wadan iskuuceyna ma aha it's very very wrong to characterize Garissa county as a homogeneous county we're totally different even in terms of vegetation as you will appreciate if kan waxa weyn wa the riverine this is river tana as you all know different vegetation even rainka marku inta ka daayso let's say the northern part of the country is not necessarily the amount we get in Garissa riverine in the northern part of the riverine you have the Rahole national reserve which is a nationally recognized reserve or game reserve where you find plenty of wildlife tas aidana wan u iman doona wan kasi hal doona northern ka of course I'm sure you were garnaysin waxa uu characterized by the number of large wadis ama togogga aad wad garnaysin all the way from Togweyne to Gdub and all those ones ila iyo shan wabi ama shan togog weyn ba maran oo sometimes ayagana vegetation ka lagu aqaanna waa totally different vegetation wa more of acacia and comifora geedkaas loo aqaano maartay xagarka abaqda waan garnay kana waa xagarka ama kuwa kale also lagdera oo aydana wadi ah were different lagta markay biyaha marnayso like this photo here was taken few years ago ayada oo biyo wada waa a holistic river oo iska soconaya ila all the way into Somalia marka waa a different vegetation especially as it approaches martay the western eastern and northeast of the county toward Somalia were plains you of course know also the nature of wildlife there was the granacin especially toward meelaha ay tooga ku dhamaadaan shanta afar toog ay meshay ku dhamaadaan oo banka ah waa wada garanaysiin the number of wildlife there the ostriches the giraffes and the many others toward Somalia waxa arki plains or largely ay ka kooban yihiin you know this termite hills ka iyo maxaan ku dhaha geedahaas aan geeda aan si badan so were large plains oo garab soconayeen you know shrub basically central parts ka of the county you will not find for instance if you were to analyze the Fafi plains you will not find a lot of big trees were on shrubby plains you know both Marte Fafi and partly part of Degega ayegana wa sidaas kale wa on plains also you will find quite a few Marte animals and wildlife marka wadan ama county islaama aha now coming down to the south ka wa a totally different scenario this is an aerial view of the Boni forest the Boni forest in the southern part of the county were basically equatorial Africa huge forest rainforest wayan part of the long coastal forest which stretches all the way to Zanzibar and also deep into the southern part of Somalia huge rainforest we have I'm sure we all know about it actually this is a more closer photo or picture of the Boni forest from a small inside a sandy road marka you can imagine this forest and how much rain it gets wa the amount the part of our county which gets the largest amount of rain 700 milliliters of rain on average every year that's which actually equates very well in fact in this forest we have two major lakes or buhayrat or lakes or perennial not seasonal actually maba guramba except when maybe we have a very long dry spell otherwise Lake Jerey Okale. You can see the hippos there, well, Lake Hippopotamus. So here you're talking about a county which has lakes. We never knew that. So this all came as a result of our mapping of the county. The wildlife that you'll find in that part of the county were incomparable to any other place in Kenya. Even the most famous game reserves like Masai Mara do not have the kind of wildlife that you'll find in this part of our county. But walakin, unfortunately, were unknown because they have never the resources have never been brought to the fore. There is no infrastructure. There are no hotels for tourists to go. But there you are, huge mud forests with all the kind of wildlife. In fact, initially, when the Kenya Wildlife Society mentioned a game reserve, it was mainly because the amount of elephants in there were just too many. And therefore, it was it was a forest or lotalagale in Lugu Reserve Greya, Amalugu Protected Greya, the animals. Unfortunately, a large number of them have been marty killed, but we still have quite a few herds of marty elephants which roam in that part of our county. Also, the county boasts of a small but beautiful historical window to the Indian Ocean. A 14-kilometer stretch, Ankulena High Coastiga. If you were to look at that map there, this is Lamu, and that is, of course, the Indian Ocean. That is Somalia. That small spot there belongs to our county. Well, 14-kilometer stretch, of course, if you were to look at the later day mapiska, sidaas kuuma soo muuqanayeen. Waxay weekaan maartay in line-kan uu straight yahay, and therefore the later generation of mapiska will try to hide that 14-kilometer stretch. But we went digging into the historical map of Kenya after the independence, and we were able to find out that indeed we have an opening, a very beautiful opening to the sea, to the Indian Ocean, a 14-kilometer stretch, which has quite a few historical, aspects that are very, very visible. Remains of mosques, ruins of Marte towns, tombs, and many other things. And a small population, a fishing, population. Qoladan Boniga, Qolayra Somalia, Ayadigan, and also quite a few grazing around the very, very rich forest around that area. The town or the area there is largely known as Dar es Salaam. Marka, also there you are, an opening towards the sea that also was largely unknown and only came about as a result of our serious mapping of our resources as a county. Also a county well connected to Nairobi. I mean, if you were to look at the distance that we cover between our town, between our county and Nairobi for that matter, dadka waxay u maleeyaan Garissa inay tahay markii magaceeda la sheegay meel aad u fog, in the wilderness of northern Kenya. But in reality, we are more closer to Nairobi even than Mombasa, even than Kisumu for that matter. We are therefore a county well linked to also the other parts of Kenya. Our other large potential in terms of resource mapping and potential Wahawayan were our livestock. The livestock sector, the biggest chunk of livelihood in our county. As you can see, 55% of our people Wahaikunoli in livestock, and therefore it is necessary in Anaga Kolka and Hug and Sarna, that sector, and we make the best value out of it. Whether it is processing the meat, the milk, and all sorts. As you all know, also Countigan, wa Countiga and Dahno, it has the largest livestock market in East and Central Africa, and it truly. It is, particularly in terms of the number of livestock or measures lakena on a weekly basis. But unfortunately waa una laga soo gata on livestock ayadoo maxooli baan laga geystay Nairobi iyo meelaha kale. We now need to move on to the second phase, i.e. to process the livestock meat. But those are the issues as a county government we are supposed to be dealing with. Farming potential, you know, great. We are a blessed county. In fact, many people may not know this, but we are a county with two rivers. One, of course, you all know, is River Tana. And the other one is the Waso Nyiro. Waso Nyiro, as you all know, Wawigas ki imado all the way from the Abadea Mountains. Marku imado this area of the Lorian Swamp. Anaga wahandana Banka Waso in that, you know, between us and Habaswain or Wajir South. That swamp, basically, the river ends up there, but in reality, it doesn't end. The river now continues underground into what you all know are known as the Merti Aquifer. Now, the Merti Aquifer is a flowing river. You only need to dig about 200 meters, and there you have good, clean, sweet water, which indeed is the water that also serves the entire, that section of the county, or underground river, which ends up all the way into the Indian Ocean, or Mitkas, Maray, Dadab, and whatever. So rivers generally in the world are either on or undershore. Marka, that one is therefore the other river. Now, interestingly, potential agriculture in our county, therefore, we have been concentrating historically doing a bit of farming around this part of the river. But here nothing has been done, even though this is, for instance, the Waso Plains, or rather the Lorian Swamp, which we have seen. Now, soil kahadat firisa were very rich alluvial soil, and therefore very, very fertile for any kind of food cropping, fodder growth for the livestock. Wonderfully, Marte, rich wayan. Marka, in fact, the British colonial government, many years ago in 1947, were doing a mapping of the potential agricultural areas of northern Kenya, or the NFD, as it used to be called. Marka, they were quick to identify clearly that the Lorian Swamp is indeed one of the greater areas for growing for agricultural production, in addition, of course, to the River Tana. So the potential, therefore, both in the northern part of the county and also in Garissa and the south along the river, is great. So you really ask yourself, that only 600 or 700,000 kalia, or intas or potential kawan for agriculture, both in the north and in the south, why do we have to go hungry? And those are the issues we have been addressing, and how do we overcome. Tourism potential is even more wonderful in terms of what we found out as a mapping. For instance, Garissa County were among the very few counties which have got a large number. We have got actually three registered known game reserves. Down there, as you have seen earlier, we have the Boni National Reserve, which is the Boni Forest, the wildlife there. And then just slightly above it, Wahajira, the Arawale, game reserve, where you find the famous Hirola antelope. And of course, you have the Rahole. Now, this is in addition to the many other wildlife also at Kuarkeisa, Amalagahilayo, let's say the Lagdera area, the Waso Plains, and which we all know. But these are where we have concentrations, huge concentrations of wildlife still in large numbers. If you were actually to look, this is now the Kenya map, the official Kenya map of game parks and reserves. Hadad Firisa, probably there's no other county which can really come out so clearly in terms of animal concentration or wildlife concentration. So potential and Adi Hem Bakachira in terms of wildlife, unfortunately, as I mentioned, Wali Lama exploit graining because of lack of infrastructure. Some of the animals you will find there in our game reserves, particularly in the south, were very rare, were actually endangered species, as you all know, like this one here, the hirola. We have taken, Anaga as a county, we have taken the hirola to be an animal of heritage for our county, because you all know, county kali o manta ay ku hartay ama laga helayo wa county gena weyan. Sida so kale, the garanuk, which you all know, and the garanaina, wa ayadana, waxaan u qaadanay inay tahay an animal of heritage for our county, because until recently, after ay ka soo aratay Somalia ama ay ka soo dhamaatay meesha kali ay ku soo hartay Garissa County bay ahayd. Surprisingly, not even in Wajir or Mandera. It was plenty in our county until recently when it moved on to the neighboring game reserves or Kuan Isiolo Southka, iyo Samburu, and part of Samburu. But before that, the only county ay joogtay anagu aha, and we still have a large number of them, although we continue to lose Marte, quite a few of them because of... So the Garanuk also were an animal of heritage for our county. This animal is found only in our county, in the Boni Forest, where a unique small animal, wahala daha elephant shrubal, it's called elephant shrew because of that long nose. Marka, you can imagine it was being searched for many years, melaha ukuhare, and it was only discovered that it's only probably few of them are remaining in our county in the Boni Forest or in the neighboring Arabuko Sosoke, Sokoke Marte or the Malindi area, or Kilifi County. Also, this monkey was a unique primate, Wayan, which actually has unique features. As you can see, normally, Gate Kakan. Ama monkey caadi ahaan sida bin aadamka ayu shan farood leeyah shan farood waa kamil ba u yihiin, except this one here, it has no thumb, it only has four fingers. Marka, also it's found in the Boni Forest in that lower part of the county. Similarly, also this one here, the Manga Bay monkey, were another unique one, again found between us and the Tana River, towards the delta of the river. In terms of the availability of this unique animal also. Marka, all that really means our potential for agriculture and for wildlife species, particularly those endangered, were very huge. But unfortunately, again, Sidan Shege, Lama Marte exploit grain. Mining were a big potential. For instance, gypsum, as we all know, gypsum, actually our county, all the way from the region known as Degega, ila iyo past Modogashe, towards Habaswein, that whole belt wa gypsum rich wayan. But of course not exploited. So among the things ubahan in eventually lugusamaya exploitation. Marbolka, this is a stone that we all know, easily converted into construction, into marble, into tiling, both inside and outside. Marka, the ward in our county known as Danyere Ward is rich in this. Actually, for those of you, I'm sure, or Meshas Aganan, Luka Aganan, Hawaiian, were very rich in marble, both inside and even outside. As you drive, you see, miles and miles of, marble just lined up. If you were to drive further north towards, for instance, Banane, you'll find also the chalk stone, rich, all the way towards Wajir, particularly as you dig slightly into the ground. But again, you'll find amples of them also lying around Banane and those areas, for those of you who also come from that region. Marka, we are a county indeed blessed with many things. I've just picked some of those ones. Similarly, of course, we do have the possibility of the existence of large deposits of oil. In fact, as I stand here, there are two companies currently prospecting for oil in our county. So the question in reality, with so much of potential, why did our region lag behind the rest of Kenya? Because we have so much, we have water, we have land, we have the resources, we have the wildlife. We are not a poor country by any means. We are not a desert country by any means. Desert, ask me what a desert is, because I've lived in the deserts of the Arabian Peninsula for many years. Those are deserts, Mashan Desert Majra. So the reason why we lagged behind, unfortunately, because this was largely as a result of conscious and deliberate public policy choices in the past history of our country, unfortunately in Kenya, even during colonial times. But for instance, for the students of history who may be interested, please go back and read the sessional paper number 10 of 1965, that's after independence, of course. In that paper, what parts of Kenya should be developed consciously, and the decision they took was that, how much priority should be given in investing in less developed provinces? That was the question they were addressing. To make the economy as a whole grow as fast as possible, development money should be invested where it will yield the largest increase in net output. This approach will clearly favor the development of areas having abundant natural resources, good land and rainfall, transport and power facilities, and people receptive to and active in development. So basically, as long as at those days you did not have transport or power facilities, as long as you are not receptive to and active in development, you were ignored. That was the policy taken by the government after independence. It's not a secret. This is something you'll easily find everywhere if you Google out for that paper. Mirka, this was a policy taken by the government, and that policy actually, for many years, has guided the government direction. That's why there are no roads, no hospitals, no universities, no colleges, no schools, no nothing in that entire region called Northern Kenya. In fact, as a way of mitigating that historical injustice, they have added some 5% into the monies that are supposed to be given, the allocations that are supposed to be given to these counties, is called equalization margin. Unfortunately, we're still waiting and wondering why that money is being held back by the national government. But there you are. So if you were there for really having that kind of policy decision on you for the last 50 years, you'd not expect to develop. And therefore, that's why our roads can be looking like that. This is the Dadaab Garissa Road. That is the Masalani Garissa Road. As you can see, Sandy Road. Marka, there was no development. Hence, for us, the coming of devolution should indeed be a blessing. Mana hadi devolution mantala dikara idda arabine kafa idaysata oo maartay kumel garta horta anaga wayan maxay leey dad waxaan aheen laga cambidhiyay for all these years, and therefore now we have an opportunity haba yarate wixina soo gaara inaan kafa idaysano oo dadkeena aan ku hormarino is the only way is the only thing that we are supposed to be doing. So that being the case, as a county, anaga watashanay, after mapping our resources, after knowing our SWOT very well, our strengths, our weaknesses, our opportunities, our threats, then we went into we moved with vigor and speed in the optimal utilization of the resources available to us for the development of our county. And of course, this is done on the basis of prudent application of the budget allocation, wixii aan helna oo dowlad aan ka helna wixii aan taxes ku aruursan karna, even though still our people are yet to come into terms with the question of paying taxes, we are giving them time inkastoo hadda wali aan ku bilaabin si aada, but we came out with something known as County Integrated Development Plan 2013-2017, which is our guiding, you know, a book, or for that matter, our guiding principles in terms of what we are supposed to do. What we did is we prioritized our interventions. Mahan ka kabilauna, inte hada daran o anshaka kabilauna, and then which comes second and third, like that, so that we don't act as though we can do everything at the same time. Because in any case, the resources given to us is quite limited. But as soon as we came on board with our first budget, we discovered that we had a large number of livelihood interventions that were critical for us to move on into. See the matter in Bia Okale, see the Afmat Okale, see the Bera Okale, see an Datki and Gajadi, we could Ijere and Oga, Wahoga Terno. And we therefore came out with more than 230 projects in those livelihood areas largely. And we spent quite a few billions of shillings, as you can see there, within our first year. Priority area number one for me and my government, of course, was to develop the water resources. Our water resources, in an hotter and wakakabana, so that also with water, then we can enhance our agricultural output or production. It's only when we have our water resources developed and we enhance agricultural production, then we can talk of providing food for our people. Why is that so? Because you can all remember, Wagi and Halkan and Ema, the campaign and Kujire, Wahankahad Laye, Debata the Nugud Adai, Dathke in 2010, Abarted Adai, Sidi Mamoink Udamaden, Sidi Badia Hora Udamaden. And we have taken a promise upon ourselves that that will never happen again, inshallah ta'ala, in our county. And that's why, even had the Abarti Yered Adai or Sanatkan Inkasto Isan Deren, Intas or Unta Ayan Gabine, as you can see, these vehicles lined up, we distributed food to the extent of 500 families per ward. So 15,000 families Ayan. Untadi and Garcini, Mayra Udarna, and very well appreciated in terms of really assuming that our people should not die of hunger. Biaha, we water trucked Melala Meshi and Sdehine, Hawayarate, Biahata Hola, Wahankura Vidin, Gawaridi, Anaga and Drain. We spent a lot of money tracking water in the last dry spell so that not a single livestock should die, let alone our people dying for lack of water. But agriculture therefore remains key, a very, very key area for us. Of course, therefore, the story is that we need to derive value from our livestock. We need to derive real value, both in terms of also the byproducts through effective management, and also to enhance agricultural output in every way possible. Interventions for Abadan Ayana Samayne, as you can see here, in terms of the livestock, by providing water. Hata Melahakar, we are growing fodder. We are now growing fodder, and you know, so that the animals can be fed. And many other issues, as you can see there. Pans kan okale hadda taqriban manta mel an sticker no wa pan laan. Even though our policy also wuxuu yahay in an aad u badanin, because marki pans kan meel kasta laga qodo waxa xumaanaya the grazing lands oo xoolaha ay daaq lahayeen ayaa la faragelinaya, and therefore there will be unnecessary overgrazing. So we would like as much as possible in that ay ku heshiyaan dadka miyiga dega in paranka aan lagu meel kasta lagu badanin inkastoo ay aad noo dhibayaan, but we have really done large number of pans over the last 2 years, so that like had oo kale oo rains ka imadeen, I'm glad to report that all our pans are full. 12 pans ka aan qodno dhanba waa noo diyaar, and the people are extremely, particularly in the central under the northern part of the county, or we will be care for again. Oska, the one very nakana kamida, wahala the Sudan grass. It grows very well, as you can see. Wa os hola idagan weyan had the policy and from next year we want actually to be growing large pieces of land using this grass, so that especially dulkan ay xoolaha ka soo arraan oo maartay oo marka abaaraha ay dhacaan inaan ku badanno cooskaas, so that you only need to spray it seed kiis um bal qadaya kor ma laga soo daadinaya mar uu roob daay ama mar roob la suugay um bal soo daadinaya oo iska baxaya. Marka we are really working hard to ensure we grow more of this in the coming years. Extension services ka ama waxyaabaha aan u qabanay livestock ka waxa kamid ah daawooyinka xoolaha oo si aad ah loogu diray extension services which were not there before. Xoolo badan baa dhamaan jiray. Report ka hadda aan soo gaaray ilaahay faldigii waxa weeye we do not have now a lot of animals dying because of disease, because a lot of extension services ayaan qabanahayna so that our wildlife, our animals do not necessarily die miyiga kuwa joogaan. Saas oo kale a number of slaughterhouses ayaan ka dhisnay tuulooyinka ama ma ahe aan dhammaytirnay. Hadda sida kan oo kale waa slaughterhouse-kii ku yaalay ama ka bilaabna magaalada Masalani. Dowladdii hore ayaa bilowday, way dhammayn kari waayse dhexdii uga tagtay. So we completed it and now it is a very, very well electricity baynu galinay more than weyaan from inside. I wish I had more photos of this, but Kanawaki Garissa, we the Garissa slaughterhouse ka waagi aan campaign ku jire ayaan tagay. Markaan tagay aad ayaan u naxay and I promised that marka adu Ilaahay soo galiya in meeshaas aan wax ka qabtaa. Alhamdulillah today we are a very, very clean facility by all means in terms of our standards. Marka asagana hadda waa good functioning. Saaso kale this is a tannery wa meesha tannery of Somali maxaa u dhaa xoolaha maqaarka ha yaa lagu angajiya ha yaan maqaarka meesha lagu angajiya weeyaan ama lagu habeeya lagu magdiya ha. So basically waxa ugu bilaawna laakiin waxba kama jirin dhexda lagu isaajiye. Hadda waan kamil yelne, hadda qalabka baan u gadahayna, waxaan doonayna insha Allah ta'ala by March next year inuu noqdo a fully fledged state of the art modern tannery. Oo hadda maqaarkan uu iska qaadanayo oo duurka iska geysanayo oo wadamada countyashka loo qaadanayo in meeshaas lagu hagaajiyo oo warshado mutakaamil ah inuu noqdaan waa ayadana plankeena, maadaama hadda meeshii aynu habayne. Marka beeraha farminka potentialka aan ku leenahay wabigana Tan River 28,000 hectares ayaa la beeri karaa oo very, very comfortably loo beeri karaa oo dhul fiican u yahay. Laakiin hadda inta kale laga beero waa only 2,700 hectares, which is nothing. So really you're losing out on the entire other area. Waxa ka baxay geedkan la dhahaa madenge baa ka baxay waxba lagu qabto. So anaga hadda waxaan bilaawnay kolka inaan dhulkan aan qardayna oo sanad kasta aan qayb weyn ka qardayna oo dadka loo qardaya. Dadka hadda dadkeenni alxamdulillah waxay diyaar u yihiin inay beeraha fashaan. Anagana we are really encouraging them into agro-pastoralism, iyadoo xoolihii la dhaqanaya in haddana beeraley la noqdo oo la isku wado ayaan xoog u saarahayna. Marka that is what we are doing. Marka already dadka way shaqeysanayaan, we only need to support them with these things. Dhulkii oon u banayna rehabilitation of the infrastructure ki in Jama hadda oo kale 40 engine ayaynu u qaybinayna beeraleyda, inkastoo plaanyaheena dambe ay noqon doonaan inaan intaas ka gudubno oo siyaabo kale oo beeraha lagu waraabiyo aynu u gudubno seediska oo aynu ku siino free. Marka dadka aad baa loo shaqeynaya. The agricultural output of the county has increased very well over the last 2 years ki meesha aan ku jirnay. Maxaa yeelay support fiican oo extension, it's called extension services, oo horaan u jiri jirin ayaan u gudbinahayna in terms of supporting them with seeds, with fertilizers, qof wixii fertilizer rabo, with water marta pumpiska and so forth and so on. And luckily people now are turning to farming whether they're men or women or youth, well, it's kala bahay wixii hore oo ma arta li jiray beer ma falan karno. And even for that matter, you can see we are now into modern styles or technologies of farming, like the green housing. It's quite common now in along the river. This is an example of the kind of mixed Marte farming, very successful farm called Wadajir Farm in Garissa. You can see, quite mixed and indeed very, very lavish. Sidasokale in the northern part of the county, Balambala, Jarajara area, also good mixed farming, especially rice. They do quite some good rice growing there. Even this lady here, you can see. Well, this is a photo from Jarajara Rice Farm in that part of the county. Hada, actually, we are going now to create a factory, a rice mill in that area. It is within our budget for 2016 that we create a good rice mill in that area so that the people can now actually supply the county. You can see even the kind of everything that you grow along that river, it is possible. Arkesa, the onions that are actually coming out from our farming areas. Dulka and leyahay wan qardaynayna aad u weyn yahay hada wan bilawnay the first 200 acres mar dhaxdan ayaan isku tagnay with some help also from the Red Cross. These are 200 acres in that area called Kasha, Kasha area of Saka Ward, Ayankabilaunai, and we are continuing. We will continue to ensure that we clear more land for the people so that a Bertan. Beehives, they are into quite diversified activities. Wahbadan by Semen Hayan, Anna Hakarbe Hagajinayan, Wala Bilawi, Khastan Dumarka, Marka, there is more activity in the county and gate can I add no dibahaya, as you all know, this weed. Luckily, I have been talking to some investors from the UAE, they want to farm it and convert it into energy. Intil guro aya wahalaga so sari energy, which actually can supply our energy requirements in the town. But there has to be a solution for this. This weed were very, very dangerous weed. Target Kenya in terms of agriculture is that inshallah in 3 years' time, we expect the sector to satisfy the bulk, if not all, of the food requirements of the county. Kajadambe ina nakabato dakiyan uda madan madoni inshallah taala. Wehi an county gan kaso gosano ayawhan islenhai within the next 3 years will be enough. For our county. That indeed is my philosophy. That's my target, and that's indeed my prayer and wish. Wixii la soo gooya aan ku samaysan karno agricultural production, small scale industries ka lagu bilaabi kara. Sida hadda mid ka mid ah tomato oo kale oo aad garanaysiin markaas way soo go'da, wayna halawda. Hadda already guriga waan dhisnay oo warshada aha. Mar dhaw waxaan doonaynaa inaan aan bilaawnaba in dumarka ay meesha ku shiidaan tomatoomta oo ay soo saaraan pastigi. Hopefully by next year we should be having the first tomato paste production in Garissa. Of course waxaa naga maqan powerga oo aad garanaysiin dhibkiisa, laakiin we are going to be applying, waxaan isticmaalaynaa the normal genset ka hadda aan gadanhayna, so we can start with it. But the good news is that waan ina tusi doona the national grid. Hada marro garsu iman doona, we expect national grid in Nusogaro by 2016, if not the later part of 2015. Marka 2016, our county, inshallah ta'ala, will be well linked to the grid, especially in the southern part. Marka hadu Nusogaro power gana, then really we are on track to development and to industrialization. Mahayale, that is the essence, energy is the essence of small scale industries. Haga health sector ka daan u gudba, health sector ga shaqooyin badan baynu ka qabanay, waxaanu ku bilaawnay after we were on board, waxaan ku bilaawnay something we called the health sector strategic plan. A very, very big plan which mainly wuxuu ku saabsanaa inuu la dagaalanka dumarka iyo caruurta umul raaciin umul raaca county ashan northern kenya waxay ku jiraan kuwa ugu badan wadanka dadka u dhinta ama hooyooyinka u dhintaan umul raaca marka inaan la dagaalano taas ayaa kamid ahayd sidan oo la dagaalami lahayn waxa kamid ah anagii oo horta ishtaalihi meel kasta gaarsiina the health centers ka meel kasta la gaarsiiya oo hooyooyinka ku umuli karaan ama lagu daaweyn kara in ishtaalaha meeshay ka jirina ambulance la heli kara oo soo qaadi karaan in daaweyinkii si degdeg loo gaarsiin kara intaas marka aan ku mashquulsaneyn markaan meesha aan soo galnay the biggest crisis ka oo haastay the health sector in Garissa wuxuu ahaa understaffing waxa arki ishtaalo badan oo la dhisay ama CDF lagu dhiso ama sikal lagu dhiso oo iska shaqa oo iska xiraan oo lagu leeyahay staff looma hayo 200 staff ayaan hal mar qornay as you can see them and today ilaahay fadligiis ma jiro ishtaal u xiran shaqaale la'aan the all our health facilities in the county are functioning and fully provided for not only in terms of staff but also in terms of dawayinka dawada we make sure that you know we supply them very well to all the areas and continuously we follow up in a garden and that you know the supplies are available sida sokale ambulance ka were very very important county wa wenyahay terrain ka ama roads ka wa garanaysin wa xunyihin so in la hela ambulance available ah in every ward at least in every ward in laga heli kara ama u dhawaan kara you know ambulance aya no aha goal ilaahay fadligiisna waan gaarnay today anaga oo intaas oo ambulance martin soo gadanay oo bixinay oo ku wareejinay wardiska iyo isla markaasna waad maqashay inaan la galnay long lease with Abbas Guled Red Cross inaan la galnay lease oo ka kareysanay seven ambulances or state of the art you know grade A each of these actually were like were a moving mobile hospital wax kasto gudaha ku wata x-ray geesi maxay you know first aid key so that if a mother today was to be carried you know she can easily give birth in there and hopefully reduce the problem that we have been having marka saaso kale ishtaal kan Garissa oo aad garanaysiin shaqo badan ayuu u baahan yahay hadda qayb weyn baan ka gaarnay inaan ku bilowno oo ay ka mid tahay ishtaalka mortuary muqabil all these years can you imagine we are calling this hospital a level 5 hospital level 5 waxa la rabaa inuu yahay macnaha level 5 waa darajada ka hooseysa level 6 level 6 waxa weeyaan sida kenyatta hospital kale iyo they have everything anaga level 5 baan leena waa nahay waa provisional hospital buu ahaan jiray serving all of maarte northeastern province and tannery and even some parts of maarte the other counties neighboring counties but it never had even a mortuary so had the mortuary was done it has already been constructed we launched it we did the foundation stone sometimes last year and when I was leaving the country I was told it's ready and hopefully when I go back we launch it 100 bed maternity hospital maarte wing ma undisayna already now you know the tendering process is going on so that you know it can really accommodate as many of our mothers as possible for maternity sila sokare you know wuxuu u baahna a huge facelift oo markaan soo galay waxa aan la yaabay oo ishtaalka aan ku arkay oo hor aan u ogeyn ishtaalka oo dhanba waxa saarna roofing oo loo aqaano asbestos I really asked you people you are in the health sector how do you have asbestos on your hospital wa contradictory way ma yaa logic ma baa waxaas marka hadda waan ka qaadnay the other day I was told alhamdulillah is over now the entire hospital is fresh with you know a far better roofing asbestos has been destroyed marka and many more things are going on hopefully waxaan isleeyahay if we cannot get the funding for constructing a modern hospital we will give this one a proper facelift There are also other things go away, a holistic overhaul by Kusamaini, so that hopefully we have a modern facility in our county. This was the launch of the foundation stone. That's the Minister for Health, Sophia Omar. That's Abdullah. For those of you who don't know him, Abdullahi, the Deputy Governor. The water sector was a big headache. Had the mention okale Muhammad Hawqab said Malinkas Wahan Jognay Gawasco. This is Gawasco water treatment plant. Oh, sorry, I beg your pardon. This is Gawasco wa meshu biga saran oo biya la ay laga intake weeyaan. You see that kana inta badan waa una la aananana waa lagu qaylni, but this is one of the most difficult operations is the treatment of water, especially anaga oo kale oo biya ay dhobayeen. You can easily see how this water is. To clean this water is not only very costly, but it cracks mashimaha. Maybe you have heard, Garissa waxaa jiray a bit of water crisis about 2 weeks ago or 10 days ago. There was nothing funny about it. It's simply because dowadas markii ay mashiimaha jiidan, it clogs the machines. So really you have to spend a lot of money, a lot of effort to cleanse them. We are now seeking some help from Turkey. I was there last month. And we hopefully will get a solution, a long-term solution to the problem. But Hadda, among the problems power. Because unfortunately, magalada waxay ku socotaa the KPLC, as you all know. KPLC ga waxa garanaysiin oo iska go'ay oo anaga shaqo kuma lihiin. Waa national government issue. It's not in our mandate. If KPLC was in my mandate, we need to do an overhaul of the gensets there. Marka go aya marka go ana biya ay fatgareenaya marka biya ay fatgareena the town says maxaa ku dhaabi marka hadda waxaan sameeyney we bought our own 1 megawatt genset. Actually this is now there's no more question of biya garsa waxay lagu in power madaxiisa because now we have our own supply which is installed there. Sidaas oo kale hadda Gawasco waxaan ku sameeynay a holistic overhaul in terms of the pumps key filters key. I hope there will be no more issue of water in Garissa town. Of course magaalada way weynate hadda shaqada kale inoo harta waxa weeye pipeyaha magaalada meesha inteeda old town kale dhigi jiray ku jirta iyo bulooyinkii waa hore ku dhawaa oo dhan pipes kala galiyay waagii hore waxay ahaayeen very very small pipes 4 inch baa ku jira 4 inch. Now that 4 inch pipe oo intaas oo sana rust qaadanayeen intaas oo sana ma artay dhobada ay xireysay ayaa hadda waxaan ku sameeyneynaa overhaul. We actually need to change the entire piping system. Markaas magaalada way weynaato maalin kasta waxaa lagu dhihi buul cusub baa la furay buul hadda tuu haliishay la maartay buula sagaar or something. And you can't control. That kind of way, it's good guy, every day there is a new bula coming up. Because I say, "Aniga, waan degan ahay bula hebel biin ma soo garan." Hadda ma lagu tala galin bal xogaa no samr oo we need to reach there. Marka it's a very fast growing town. Let's confess that. That can unfortunately sabar ku yar yahay. Marka you definitely buuqa iska soconaya. And the companies will continue, but in reality I'm giving a lot of attention to the water issue in Garissa in particular. Saaso kale miiga ama the sub counties ka aad baan ugu shaqeynayna so that there's no more water problem in our county. My target ilaahay do may dhin is that come 2016 there should not be anywhere in this county where people will complain of water. Why am I saying this? Balambala okay hadda waa magaalo weyn. We all know that. Balambala was a big town ever since Garissa was there. But can you imagine bihi wabiga kaasu maraya magaalada way ku ooman tahay because there was never any proper piping or water supply done. Hadda this is a 60 million water project to extract water from the river, create a huge reservoir for the town, and you know, then supply si caadi markaas loo qabsadaan oo tankiyada waxa loo hagaajiyo. We have already this is now almost 50% into progress. Sidaasoo kale masalani, which has actually which I can say has the now the largest water project in this county. This is a project costing 160 million Kenya shillings in Masalani. Hopefully, when this is done, Masalani will have no more water issues, Marte, and that's a very fast growing town also. All the way, yani magaloyin kan wabiga sarnayen, ever since we were a county, biyaha dibadan ba ka haystay. Dan yare aad waxa ka socda, which is the farthest corner of our county, a water project of you know 65 million. And all the towns, hata kuwa iyarka wabiga saran, ila iyo abaqdera, ila iyo what, the water supply should be through. Hopefully by 2016, 2015, we should be really done. And those towns which have been suffering for lack of water will all get water. In the other parts of the county, Dadaab, Mudugashe, Sida Sokale, the water projects are on, and we hope they will be also completed sooner than later. Everywhere, planking waxa weeye hatta magaloyinka oo ceelasha ay ku yaalaan inaan u hagaajino reservoirs, and we pump the water into the towns. I pump gar wayna, we do kiosks for the people. This question of all of everybody coming with their damerahoda to the ceelka, we want to avoid it. We have a water plan that indeed is quite robust. That really, on the water sector, I think we're doing very well. Youth affairs ka, youth ka wa a big issue. As you all know, shaqalaan ba jirta. Dhalinyaradi qaarna iskuuladi way ka dhaceen or they not perform well. There are plenty there with their low grades. Badina, you know, wa migrants from badihi ba laga imaaday. Magaloyinka ba la tuuran yahay. Marka, indeed, that's a huge challenge in the entire country, if not in the entire world. Youth ka, marka, youth kan mahayelna has been a big dilemma for me. When I came in, horta hafis ban furay, called the Youth Coordination Office. That was Marte, June 2013, as you can see. We keep knowing what the youth can do, who has what skills, and many other issues. But not quite helpful because they want shaqay raban and they have to move on. Marka hadda waxaan isku dayahay on different things. For instance, this one here was a block making machinery. This machine is called hydroform. It produces those blocks very quickly. Blockyahas ay soo saareysa, and now we want in an Melkasta and Youthka ay jogan county ga eda Garissa or Dormel and Mashiman tan u xirna ay ku shaqeystaan iyo also the sub counties ka oo aad u geyn oo ay ka shaqeystaan. So that they, when they produce these blocks, even anaga contractiha aan bixinayno for constructing our schools, for constructing our hospitals, for whatever, marka ayaga laga gato. So we're trying to work out a plan so we increase the number of these hydroform machines for those who will be willing to utilize them. Unfortunately, many times our youth are not for this kind of jobs. We have jailihin white collar jobs. We have kule shaqadan way u adag tahay mid xafiis baan raba. Mid xafiis nimo wada qaadi karaa. I mean, can we think out of that box, Martin? You know. One aspect or add no kalme say of course were very costly, but I'm sure you guys have heard about ugatuzina kazi soma tuma maqashan soma masa mesh in english waxa waan iniga ma ba madanaysin ba ugatuzina kazi actually waxa weeyaan was something a philosophy I introduced myself. I borrowed from the Tanzanians after independence. They had something called uhuru na kazi. Marka so for me, it was ugatuzi na kazi, whereby we employed many of the unemployed had 1,300 bansi marahayna. We pay each one of them 11,000. Gedi madenge magalad kuyale iyo sakhdi magalada. I hope you guys have been hearing some good news about Garissa in terms of cleanliness. Mas warka ilma wasu garawa. Thank you. Marka shaqa fi'an bay qaban hayaan, not only in Garissa, but also in the sub counties. As you can see, this was quite a demonstration they were doing when they were being launched officially. Marka youth ka, just to conclude on the youth issue, ye shaqal anta, were an ongoing struggle. Hada idea that I seen that kin and hada Europe ta joga okale, or do so bearing kartin, we will indeed appreciate so that we keep our boys and girls busy. Mahaya shaqal anta, wa udur wayan, or rather the lack of engagement. You know, they, as they said, you know, an idle mind is a devil's workshop. Marka, we really need to engage this youth as much as possible. Education ka, you are all aware that another education mainly waxaan nagu soo haagay ama aan la xalbinayno ama qaybta anaga hadda masuul ka nahay waa the technical education and also the ECDs largely. Technical ka is one area personally aan xoog aan saaray maxay leh waxaan islahaa dhalinyaradan faraha badan ha ku bartaan farsamada gacanta oo marka shaqooyin ha ku helaan. Unfortunately, dhalinyaradeena shaqadan diyaar uma aha. Waa also another headache which I'm dealing with. As you can see there, kan hadda waa school kan oo Garissa Youth Polytechnic la dhahaa weeyaan. The Minister for Education, Maal Hussein, is there. We officially launched it. Markaasa waliba waxaan tan gaazaynay. Hadda maanta laga bilaa waxaan ahnay farsamada gacanta ee ku yaala countiga iskuulahiisa, because there is one in Garissa here, there is one in Burra, there is one in Dadaab, and the others are coming up in Balambala and in Mudugashi and whatever. Waan dhisayna. Waxaan ahnay maanta laga bilaabo iskuuladan farsamada gacanta waa free. Kaala imaada wax ka barta. Hataa shan qof lama imaan. Maba rabaanba waxay ku leeyihin waxaas waa shaqa oo madowga inay ka shaqa ku leeyihin. We need a cultural change. Wax dhib yar maaha, waa arrin culus baan haysta. Actually, hadda kulay Garissa waad joogteen, waad aragteen, magaalada waxaa ka shaqeeya oo guryaha dhisa ma Soomaali ba? Soomaali ma. In fact, we have calculated, we have done our own computation, waxaa noo soo baxday every day 2 million shillings minimum ayaa Garissa ka baxda into Ukambani. Maxaa yeelay haddaad doonayso inaad xabad nalka gashato gurigaada Soomaali ma jira, waxaad raadsan Mukamba. Xabad mutafaali meel lagu sara hadaad u baahato waa inaad Mukamba raadsato weeyaan. You can imagine, of course this is a blessing in a way. Waxaan dhahaa war haddii kuwan ay jiri laheen yaaba guriga noo dhisi lahaaba, anaga waan diidnay inaan guri aan dhisanay. Because hadda everywhere aan mashruuc ka wadna maanta in our county and bilmunaasab countigeena maanta meel aysan mashruuc ka soconin ma leh. Every other village, by and large, waxaan ka wadnaa something is happening. Either a school, either an ECD, either a dispensary, either something. Marka, ayaga unbaa un dhisayaan. And actually, at a very expensive price. In fact, this man, markuu ka imaada Kitui ama uu ka imaada Ukambani, xagga wuxuu ku qaadanayaa, inta wuxuu ku qaadanayaa, double that, if not actually triple that. Because of the risk factor of whatever, but again, you know, everything has a price. So one last one behind. Marka, we have agreed, you know, to enrich other counties because our boys don't want to go into the construction sector. Arintas waxay u baahan tahay in laga tashado oo lagu noqdo. What is the solution? We have a big problem. The other area also, or either na ulas naga hisito, wa the teaching. Again, teaching ka maalinimada ama in teacher la noqdo, waayo hore waxay ahaan jirtay some kind of a fashion. Maalimin badan baan lahaan jirnay oo wiilal Soomaali ah, gabdho Soomaali ah. Hadda waa ka wada baxeen. They have gone into NGOs. Kuwi soo hareena way influence gareen. Right now, you all know waxaad ka warqabtiin inaan qabnay Garissa Teachers Training College, ma? 99% dadka dhigto waa dhigtay other parts of Kenya. down country. Weeshi igabdi Soomaali waa diin ma shee galan. Marka we are having structural social issues. U baahan in ayadana laga tashado. Marka anaga technical inaan xojino ma rabna hadda waa very very important area. Higher education, of course, we continue helping where we can. We were happy. Kenyatta University College recently, they came to launch a branch of theirs in Dadaab. There you are, as you can see, myself with Professor Mugenda launching the university. And actually has been quite helpful to a large number of those in Dadaab who want to continue with their education. Very good campus there. Alhamdulillah, also a county scholarship program, as you can see, whereby an awutala galnay dhalinyarada kuwooda specifically education, I mean haga afimaadka medical. If you are a student who is doing medicine or who wants to do medicine and you are struggling with fees, if you are a student who has got admission for engineering anywhere in Kenya or in East Africa or in Kabihina, because those are the qualities or the areas we need to develop. Unfortunately, arurteena waxay u bateen on artska. We are not a county that's developing talents outside the arts area. Waxa arki, you know, HR. How many HRs do we require? I mean, you know, it's just too much. HR ba ninkasta u lordaa u kuleeyaa waxaan soo qaatay HR or other similar things. Marka, we really need to, Marka, that's also something we worked on over the last 2 years. Education ka, dibka naga hasta wala socotiin. Our county has been trailing in the results, both for primary and secondary. Waad ka warqabtiin, aniga waagi hore aan soo galay meesha, wixiina kala qabsaday aniga macallimiinti. I was very, very categorical and very tough. Waxaan dahay, TSC needs to suck a large number of the teachers in Garissa County, mahayalay, record koda, unfortunately, maquraxsano, ila hadda. Maalimint aad ba lagu soo qaylay, you know, qaad ba isku cunayeen, ma imaanayeen, a lot of issues umba unla shagawun. Because as you all know, education, wuxuu ka kooban yahay, the teacher, the parent, and the student. If any one of this triangle is not performing, then the education system will fail. Unfortunately, anaga, the weaker link wuxuu noqday the teaching part. Macallimiinta oo wax maadeen markii aan dhahay macallimiinta hala wax laga qabtana, you know, that was found to be a bit too political. It was politicized, unfortunately. But hadda, because we are trailing badly, iskuuladi are not performing. Of course, education anaga as a county government, I wish education was under the county government. Of course, education was kowar qabtiin waxa la haray the national government. Is not a function which is devolved. I wish it was devolved because I would have done what I'm supposed to do. Marka hadda, because I can't do much, I formed something called County Education Board. Or Maalim Idris, Maalim Idris Solomon Garnay. He's an educator. He was actually my school principal. He's a man we respect a lot in our county. Hadda, he's retired, but we told him, Maalim, can you please come back and help us with this county? In terms of education, but I'm sure Elin Karno, the days when we were under you or under students who were in, he is really an educator. Marka, let's hope that Manidris and his team, including Maal Mawlud there, Abdul Salam, I hope this team now will move the, we are giving them all support at our level as a county, although again, as I said, education is not a devolved function for us. Energy, we are trying over the last 2 years. Even though we are kept very busy, as you know, we have been trying some few good things in Garissa, like this. Balahan, waxaan galinay 21 floodlights baan galinay magaalada, and really they have been very, very helpful, particularly for security purposes. Meel badan oo mugdi ahayeen oo wax u maartay ayay wax fiican ka qabteen. Tulooyinkana waxaan galinayna, we have already sent 10 of them to 4 of the sub county main towns ka. Masalani and a few others, so that they can also start now bring and for that matter also, as you can appreciate, the street lighting key is also going on, so that you know we can also bring some lighting and some life to our dark streets. Energy, the most important piece of news that I can report, the grid. The national grid is coming to our county. This is really the biggest achievement, or rather the biggest hope, or rather the biggest aspiration we have. In grid no imado. This is a county land. We give them to build the station. Grid kamarku imado wa inu meshi ukuso hermila lo siya gajia or station kaha. Dul bam bhenai last March, I think, and it was a big function attended by myself, the majority leader, and also Goladikale. In the northern part of the county, Magalada lo aqana bananay is now the first sport in northern Kenya. I can say the first sport in northern Kenya, in the entire northern Kenya, banana now has become the first sport to be fixed to the national grid. How did that happen? It happened by some kind of, I wouldn't say by magic, but by a bit of smartness. Anigo o malin usuudo isyolo, I decided to drive by road from Banane. And I discovered Garbatula, which is only 17 kilometers, actually grid wujogoba. So the national grid was in Garbatula, and we are only 17 kilometers. And I spoke to this man, Mr. Nganga. He is the man in charge of REA. REA wa nima kalo agano, Rural Electrification Authority. We struck a deal in Anigana and Lakar Bihio as a county government, as a Itkaru Bihio, and actually, I can confirm Banane today is on the national grid, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. And next month I'll be there, hopefully, to go and launch that with him. And also, the first sport. There today, we can start all kind of factories. And in fact, we are planning some heavy industries to start in that part of the county, so that... Haga oil exploration ka. This is Mr. Augustine, wa the latest company to arrive in the county to do oil exploration. It was a US-based company called Kamak. They are now prospecting in Fafi sub county. This is Salah, the minister for energy of my county. Rodiska, we have been struggling with different things. As you all know, this is the big one, the Garissa Modogashi Road, or national government tiga a masul katahai, or lakte de haiso. But luckily, the money is coming from the Saudi Development Fund, and I know them. Marka inti ila iyo hadda labasana o arintan la ansahanay, wa undabasuane. And by our consistent follow up, the ministry has now advertised the tender. It was in the papers about 2 weeks ago. We hope by January the road should start. The construction of Garissa Modogashi Road should start, so that inshallah ta'ala, we can easily then talk of a link to Modogashi and that northern part of the county, and complete a very, very important aspect of our county. Wadada Naito, Wadada Kismai Road Garissa. It has been called Sururu Road by the Facebook Haleban Ogu Shekena in Monkey Birmingham. Somalida Sabarida. Unfortunately, Wahalo Bihia Sururu Road. Sururu Road, Sururu. Maya anaga in Gufor Jenain, Hedhen. Waxaa la wadada waa sururu maxay dhayn maxay ragana wadada ku qodahayo sururu da now markii wadada sururu lagu qodayay hadana ugu sheekay nimanka reer Birmingham waxa weeye wadada wada cusub oo dhisay ma aheen we were recapitating it we were doing some proper recapitating and actually we were doing a favor for the national government anaga wadada masuul kama nihin this is an air road wa a national road waxa ku shaqul lahayd kenha oo ku ciyaartay oo lacagteedana xamaarta haleeyeen oo qarsadeen laakiin maadaama magaalada ay marayso ay tahay main road wixii baan u gagsan waynay So we said, let's help Kenha. Marka waxaan u yeernay nimanka Kenha engineerski waxaan dhahnay wadadan iniga mas'uul ka ah anaga lacagta bixinayna come and supervise ka iniga supervise ku sameeya oo noodhisa way naga yeeleen marka waxay dhahayn to remove the top layer kan oo laamida ah taraktada ma marinayno hadaan taraktada marino waxay u dhici arada hoose iyo maxaan kugu dhaa marka rag badan bay qoreen oo baash ka qaaday maxaan kugu dhaa sururuda laakiin Soomaali sabar yarideeda waa garnayna intii baa la fiirsan waayay markaas Facebook oo laga buuxiyo on sururu road I always joke waxaan dhahaa Soomaalida sabar yarideeda caadi maaha marka I'll talk about that later but there you can see we're done a very beautiful road now has come out and we are proud of it. It has actually brought Kismay Road. Waxa kale oo aan ka wadnaa tuulooyinka ama laga qabtayba wadooyin aad u fara badan. Not necessarily laami ma aha, laakiin you can see we have really been doing a lot of maraming to improve on the road network in the county. This was a visit by Abdullahi, the deputy governor, to the Wema Road. I think this is Wema Road in Masalani. This is the sub-county administrator for Masalani, and this is for Ijara. For Huluko. Marka, Abdullahi now is in charge basically of ensuring all projects are done perfectly well. Haga abanka, I'm just rushing quickly into some of the things. This is not all that we have done. We have done many, but I've just decided to share with you some few highlights. Magalada goorti aan qabanay waad garanaysiin waxa ka buuxay baalahan oo loo aqaano dashishka. Dib weyn baan naga qabsaday magalada kuwan aan ka qaadna. Waad la socotay warka maartay say ahayd. Gabdhihi meelaha wax ku karsanaaye meel baan u habeynay. And an haga ugura waxaan foolxumo weeyaan waa naga diideen so it's a big fight basically but eventually we showed them some logic way naga yeleen and the town now is clean saaso kale waxaan ka bilaawnay magaalada waxa la dhaha communal cleaning in an every month as soo baxna magaalada aan clean gareyna laakiin unfortunately waan u bilaabay abaar baan la waday Soomaali baan nahay waa ila socon la yihiin marka maybe we will need to have some few of you guys coming forward to help us. Markets ka every town or sub county headquarter waxaan ka dhisihayna a market for the ladies, modern market. And I think by now a number of them, Modogashe, Masalani, Balambala, all Homenaya Bura Waldamei ama were almost being complete. Marka really I've gone around all the sub counties to launch the markets to the foundation stone. We hope in an Mardow Ayagana in Kondonta. This is our upcoming disaster management center, fire station. We'll have there Marte Melha Egwarda Galan. We have already procured 4 vehicles, as you can see, the first 4 vehicles. And also, other disaster activities, management, should the flood, should the droughts. So we'll have one area where we'll do all our disaster, and we're getting some training, luckily from the Turkish government, so that they can give us full-fledged training on how we do our disaster. Some of the highlights, waxa kale oo aan ku mashquulnay muddo hadda yar aan soo dhaafnay waxa weeye creating some good relations with the outside world waxa la dhahaa no man is an island dowladna kuma socon karto ana isku filan you can never be complete waxa weeyaan marka in a diamond rest of friends to support you waa loo baahan yahay among the first friends ka aan helnay oo si fiican wax noola qaban hayaan waa nimanka turkida this is tika Tika was the Turkish foreign investment, foreign relations support Marte, while like JICA your organization, USAID was way by Lamitai. Whatever had a shelter, a full-fledged maternity wing or a inoga design Masalani town at a price or at a cost of 80 million 80 million shillings by inoga design. Very welcome. Equipment badan by no canon or modern state asri or usub Garissa hostel by no canon 120 million shillings ay no kalmayen had hostel ken amount Garissa except for some big items like dialysis your MRI your or hada an gadan ramno intakal odamba we have every equipment that you may require in a modern level 5 hostel. Sidaso kale, this is the Minister for Environment of Turkey. Wa Noimadi, a very, very great man, Asaga Yoninkan, Ismail Haki, these are friends of mine. Wahi no kenen gawaridan arkeisin, or lihda'a. We are the first county in Kenya to have these vehicles. Wa gawarida o wasakda gadan. Marka, unfortunately, Malink ugu horaba wiilashi aan u dhiibnay waa la boodeen you know Marka, we are having issues but Marka, actually nimankii baan oo naxariista waxay dhahayn wiilashan gabadha khatar bay gelinayeen waxaan ku dhiseynaa ma arta modern garage only specifically for this makhadab we know this and had the market garashina so it's quite interesting ha kale oo nimaan la wadna had relations ka or very important the World Bank. This is the World Bank president. You are aware they were in Dadaab recently. Hayalaya you all aware refugees ki walaalaha ay meesha degana culays badan bay ugu qabteen in terms of dulki nabaad guurkiisi iyo wixii iyo marka waxaan aad isku dayaynaa inaan helno support. We want to plant 10 million trees between now and 2017. We want support for growing 10 million trees in that area. Mahayley, I'm sure ragiinan ama dadkiinan tagay Dadaab waa aragteen Dadaab has become largely a desert now, especially inta magaalada iyo xarooyinka maad agteeda ah, which is unfortunate. Dadaab may ahaan jirin dhul abaar ah oo geed la'aan ma ahaan jirin. In fact anaga waxaan dhihi jirnay dhib ma jirin, maxaa la dhihi jiray Dadaab aar ma dhihi jiray. Marka it's unfortunate, so I'm talking to these people so that they can give us support with growing or rehabilitating. This is also another very important link which I have created with the IDB or Islamic Development Bank. This is the president of the bank, Reggie Malinka Imadu Kamidaha. Wala halay already wuna soo diray haddii wuna soo diray maalo dadna la joogen Garissa oo maartay ku tala galay ama ku heshiyay in waxyaabo badan ay la qabtaan so that we can improve our situation. Now some other interventions ama issues ka oo hada aan qabanayno ama aan ku plan gareynayno magaalada waxa kamid ah tourism ka umada hadii aysan helayeen meel ay u qaado tarfiih to go and you know see animals, see some few other things, hata ilmaha ya caruurta holiday god uu ka halaabaya ciid ba iman caruurta inta la geeyni you know waxa meel aan ku soo nasto oo baarta waxaan soo arko nature baan u baahanahay. Marka really we have wildlife. You have seen countigan were among the very few counties or qaban you know 3 game reserves. Like unfortunately game reserves ki wa naga fog yihiin lama develop grainin roads ki ma qabno kuwaasna hadda waxaan dhigi karna maanta ibra ku gaan gaari karna ma to do one tarmac road for tourism to the southern part of our county is a huge investment probably few years from now. Marka waxaan ku fikirnay in magaalada Garissa aan ka hagaajino some game park, a park just like Nairobi has Nairobi National Park. In Garissa anu hagaajino Garissa Park ayaan ku fikirnay. Marka waa tashanay waxa noo muuqatay meeshan loo aqaano Garissa Giraffe Center. Soo ma garanayshin Garissa Giraffe Center وامل مقاله كده حتى له. It is there. The wildlife already is there. جراف وحاس كي مادي أو إله إسكا كاني. You know أو أسوق قولي بنقص وقلا ما أرتي حقن يو دداب. وحكسو على you know the refugees who are attacking it. مركا this is the giraffe. And not only the giraffe, but that area, because giraffe can away so rasenayin, a lot of other wildlife balugo arkay, both herbivorous and also carnivorous. Marka, we have decided to create the first park, animal park, in this place. Marka wahan kutashanay inan hagajino a modern. This is the artist Marty drawing of how the entrance will look like. Of the already lacked had one with the is going to cost us about 200, 300 million. We are putting now the plan together. Already drawings were not allowed then, as you can see. This is the entrance of the proposed Marte Center. A small hotel or traditional. As you can see, this is Wagal Heria Wayan. Like in Kan Agal Heria or Dagat Wayan, Dagat Bulehai. Erid Bulehai. Marka waxaan u hagaajinay a platform because meesha waxa lagu sheegay inay qabto a lot of massage iyo hangarla waxa siya so at adanka meesha ay lagu qarinay waxaan dhahnay we raise it so we are also this was a well thought plan between us and our architect so really this is a unit now of course inside there wa aqal heri as you can see but wa whole modern hotel room with TV, with toilets, all inside. Marka, but that's the design we have developed from the outside, so it looks like a traditional Somali home. So this is really the artist's smart impression of how the first 10 units will look like. This is our conference hall. We'll also do a local makuti. This is our administration block. A restaurant there, and then out of that door into the now, and you go and see a few other things. And outra galamesh in legahagajio. Activities ka we will expand it. For instance, we'll bring in a crocodile park ha or farm. Why am I saying this? Crocodiles they have just become too much. In the river. In fact, close as last Eid, ilmuna gune. Marka ana waxaan dhahay baadha inta ku ilmaha laga dhagay anaga aan keenay waat we aan meesha ku soo aruurina maar so that we benefit from it yani why should it continue eating our children for no value. So and incidentally wali lama fam grain but barkan wa a huge requirement in Southeast Asia. Aad ba loo gataa asaga iyo mirihiisa maxaa la bahala ukuntiisu ciisiyo way aruursadaan marka hadda we have already started some discussion with some Korean investor inuu imaado and we do a farm together asna anaga aruursada ma arday ukuma anagana they are already doing it in Isiolo so anagana waxaan noo imow kale ma arday inala qabo marka other activities or measure and canina, we have made a primate zoo. Who had an arcane, Bali had an arcane to say, I am mesh canina, the manga bay. Those are very, very rare animals. We need to introduce them here so that they are protected from extinction. Also, we'll have a tortoise marty, park there for the children to come and see. Waxaan keenaynaa wax alla wixii ciyaartooyin oo dhaqanka ah I'm sure you know this museum right ninkaas wal garanay soo maninkaas hadda waxa asaga wuxuu noqday part of the government waxa weeyaan team buu leeyahay oo entertainment ah oo khatar ah marka he is part of the government so he will also saaso kale gabdhaha iyo hidaha iyo dhaqanka inaan soo celino oo si aad ah ayaan doonaynaa maxaa yeelay dhaqanka Soomaalida wuu guurahayaa marka inaan soo celinno soo isku kuma heshin insha Allah ta'ala. sidaas oo kale inaan maartay aan ciyaartooyinka sida tartankan oo kale hata midkan waa horna waa in sheegay dibka ugu weyn magaalada gaas naga haasto waa ka indhahay waa dameeraha marka anigu dameerahan waxaan dhahay baad waxa ka dameeyaa inaan meel hagaajin ay ku ciyaaraan maarto oo lagu heeyo dameer iska farabatay waxa la aadan garanayeen magaalada iska wareegayeen I need to employ them very well or better than that marka we will bring them to the park there so that they become part of the entertainment in that area also we are thinking of doing even excursions we become could we in an excursions u sameeyno or boats ka soo kale mar soo lagu sameeya if you go to the river even downstream or upstream ka it's used why not in Garissa we are part of them and we need these ideas to come from you people again in diaspora ga joga so noqda these opportunities now had no imam waysin I don't know really who will come and now I have an investment opportunity and this investment opportunity waxaan doonayaa inaan mar dhaw aan soo laabto oo ayadoo mutakamil ah oo macluumaadkeedi waxa ay wadato inaan soo bandhigo iniga iyo dad kale diaspora ku nool not because we cannot get money but because I want to give the opportunity also to the people of Garissa this opportunity waxa weeye the Garissa central market suuqi waan dhisayna suuq muddo dhig jiray we've already planned it it's going to be a 3-story building a huge facility are you going to know inshallah markaan dhisno suuq nur baa loo bixin doonaa suuq muddo waa laga qaadi marka you can see a modern state of the Adman Kadisahina with a lot of amenities and facilities intas iyo ka badan ayaa ku dhex jira waa 2000 modern stalls public health unit rest areas management offices washrooms waxa ku jira police post man ka dhex dhisayna for security waxaan ka dhex dhisayna garbage disposal fighting station firefighting station and many other things marka lacagta meeshan ku baxaysa waa about 1.5 million US dollars sidib yari ah ayaan doonaynaa inaan lacagta aan dadka aan fursad investment uga dhigno waxaan sameynaynaa waxa loo aqaano sharia compliant fund baan hagaajinaynaa oo ah units you buy units in that fund how does it work waxaan sameynaynaa that 1.5 ba maybe loo qaybinaya inta soo unit and every unit can cost you about $100 so it depends how many units you want to buy hada taban gadanayso that boqol gadan depending on your strength wa shares basically exactly how our shares are so you buy shares in that fund or that investment company and within 4 years maximum your money will come back to you with also a huge profit because mission will be indeed profitable mahayle wa kireneena with good money wa more than wayan hadda already orders keys is your mart application ka login sanaya so mail an garimba ay farabdan tahay marka you will not go wrong with this one here marka insha Allah diyar mootidin very good so that means I will come back hopefully sooner than later or maybe I will send somebody or in sharh doona so that you can then hopefully invest wa good investment or an khasara lehen inshallah ma hayalay wa backed by a whole facility wa secured ma yaani wax oo lacag oo inta baa laga iska tooray dhumaysmaha marka inshallah taasna wa waxyaabaha aan rabaa in sheego diyaar u ahada magaalada Garissa baan wax iniga sheegi rabaa magaalada neeto it was recently reported were one of the fastest growing towns in Kenya and indeed it is magaalo fiican ayuu ilaahay nasiye oo saad ogsoon tihiin ba sida inii sheegay Nairobi na u dhaw wadalaama ay isku xireysa oo aan fogeen hata Mombasa ka dhaw you know marka aad ba loo iman raba aad ba loo soo gali raba laakiin anaga ba ilaahay Soomaali naga dhige and somehow I don't know marka hada Toyota oo kale Toyota already is in Garissa kule wakawar qabteen soma were quite interesting for Toyota to discover ile e madan Garissa to open a full fledged center maaha arin oo fudud. We need to appreciate that and welcome those kind of investors as much as possible. Bangiyada, they keep coming. The last one to open a branch was National Bank, as you can see. Had the Chase Bank already is coming. They've already identified a place. And many others are on the way. I'm a banker by profession. That means not only is there money and wealth, but also potential is very high. So we also need to really harness that very much. Of course, other smaller business, Naivas. I'm sure you all know Naivas. Naivas was a supermarket chain, just like Tuskies or Kale. They came, and they are today, you know, very well, serving the town very, very well. Marka, these are not just by chance. Hata dagaalaha magaalada inuu aad u koray waxa ku dhalay gowada meesha la dhigana balaysi u yeelan. You know, it's not you know, when I saw the other day this picture of Naivas with those kind of vehicles, I said, wow, this is now an advanced mart town. Marka indeed wa magaala gaari karto magaalooyinka aad u weyn Kenya oo ka ficnaan kartaba. Marka you know, other smaller ones imaadeen waxa kamid ah Haas Petroleum, which I'm sure you have all seen, which is a good name also to be in our town. Construction is booming. This is, of course, a major construction going on somewhere not far from our offices. I'm sure you all know whom it belongs to. But Magalada is growing. It's expanding. We have a town to be proud of. Like in Su'alka waxa weeye anagi aya ilaahay Soomaali laga dhigay. My biggest fear is that this development yamaanta waxaan aan ku socono hadaan anaga iska halaynin indeed mel dheer baan gaari karnaa. To conclude my presentation, waxaan hagaajinay intii aan iga maqna while I was away. While I was maqnaysin. The county government of Garissa, this is our court of Amarte, county court of arms. Wahajirjit Kisal Baba while you are away, so in Meso Garmia. Marka, the court of arms can, Mahanabadam Bukufadia, each county now are like its own country when you make your own court of arms, you make your own flag, you make whatever. Marka, another, our court of arms is comprised of many things. This is the hirola, that animal or ankasheke, which is very rare in our county. This is the gerenuk, what is ankasheke. They are holding this shield, which is comprising of many things. This cobweb is kaneto wa our potential for agriculture. And that is, of course, our potential for livestock. That represents the river Tana for us. And the potential of using it very well. Here, of course, you can see the book, which basically means the light of knowledge, education, which we really badly require. Of course, Meshan Wahaku Arkaisin, what is that? Some minarets which represent the spiritual value and Maratai, you know, religiousness. And for that matter, kuwaso magarnaysin afsoon halu dhaha ha nimanka reesamawada ma kale waqanaan ya adigu kulayba maayba ma loo yeera, but there you are. So what traditional also value which we need to march to protect. And finally, this is a wording we borrowed from the national anthem haki iwengao. Marka that is our coat of arms. It's already approved by our assembly. This is our tagline. You know, some catchphrase for the county, home of the Hirola. Garissa County, you know, we are the home, the Hirola. you know, other countries will call themselves anything, but because this is an animal unique to us, very, very important. Flagena, not a good one, because I think the printing was bad. But this is our flag, also approved by the assembly. It has a lot of meaning. This, of course, that one is there, as you can see. It's very beautiful. I think the colors here have not come out well. But when printed very well, a very nice one. These are seven lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These seven lines represent the seven sub-counties of our county. We have six sub-counties or six constitutions or six constituents. And as a government, as an assembly, we have the powers to kalan kudarsane. Which one was that? Hulukan kudarsane. Marka, as you can see, that is really our flag, also quite meaningful. And finally, this is our seal, the seal of the county government of Garissa, as you can see with the coat of arms in there. Conclusion. We indeed have a great county. However, there is also a real fear that continues to haunt us at all times. Which fear is that? Somebody says corruption. Another one? Security. Corruption, don't worry about that, that's Kenya. Kenya Jognai. Don't worry about corruption, so much about corruption. The real fear we have in northern Kenya is what?
Security.
Insecurity. Insecurity. Waxaan leeyahay hadaan nahay Soomaali dib weyn baan haasta. We are back at right now maanta waxa ka dhacaya dhulkeena. We are back to 1963. Hadda waxa ka dhacay Madeira Macadiba. Where are we heading? Tonight awadan caawi aan joogo inaan maqsheen ma ooshay Garissa there was a grenade. Ma lagu tuuray. Who is doing this? What is their motive? Marka, really, as leaders in that area, personally, I'm having a huge issue with this insecurity issue. Mahayalay, that is the only thing or magalada say to ama nagasoo fiijin kara, ama gubi kara. Marka, ilaahay ma baranayna, waxaan ma garanaynaa. We have tried everything. I sit, of course, as you can see here, I sit with the county commissioner who represents the national government. We have a joint committee known as the County Security Committee. Actually, I'm the chairman of that committee. But unfortunately, of course, this is now the entire leadership or county Marte, assembly of Marte, county security of Marte, officers, including the KDF officer is sitting here. But maha lagabankara, things just keep coming. You know, the worst war to fight or ever to attempt to fight was a guerrilla war. It's madness. Marka, the best I can say waxa weey ilaahay aan barino kabeela joogana county gan oo naha laga soo dadaalo ha loo soo bariyo wixii xumaanta way ilaahay raay qabto wa akhir du'aana an alhamdulillah assalamu alaykum shukran jazeelan thank you.
Aad iyo aad ayaan ma taqaana u faraxsanahay inaan halkan maanta ku qaabilnay Nathif Jama from Garissa oo mataqaana aad iyo aad ayaan ugu mahadcelinaynaa dadka dhan oo ka soo qayb galay waa arrin farxad leh hadda ka hor markii uu hore u noo yimaaday waxay ahayd mataqaana ballanqaad iyo howlo la mid ayay ahayd hadda laakiin inta badan oo ballameysi inuu fuliyaan u joodnaa we are very much happy and Mr. Governor come back again to us thank you very much
waxaan soo dhaweynaynaa governor-geena anako aad u faraxsan oo governor-geena la kulanay oo waxyaalo uu ka qabta gaarisanaan aad ugu faraxsan oo aragne
welcome
governor to london
assalamu alaykum magacaygu waa rooda carab waxaan caawa ka soo qayb galay xaflada soo dhaweynta governor Nathif waxaan leeyahay welcome london een waan ku hambalyeynaynaa wanaaga aad qabatay iyo sharafta aad qabatay een waxaan kala leeyahay dhamaan een heladii iyo dadkii Garissa iyo North Eastern Kenya waxaan u gudbinayaa salaan waxaan kala leeyahay halkan laba xabo gobolka senatorkiisa iyo Geesi Yuusuf Haaji Nathif kan ku gooyay gobernaha noo aha halkay waa gobe amaan gaar ah iga geeyay